Hello guys, welcome back to our channel. So today we are going to build a Juno that can solo people at G2. This pesky Okeanos Genie Hathor user every match, yeah? We are going to build a Juno that can solo these cancers. Now for this to work, your Juno is preferably has to be on the fans to spare. And there are priorities in ruining your Junos, starting with the crit rate. Now your crit rate has to be around 85% to always crit on cancers unit like Ganymede, Hathor, or Okeanos. Even saying their name makes me wanna puke, guys. And the reason you wanna have crit rate is that the first skill is gonna give you 45% attack bar every turn, and that is gonna ensure more stuns on the opponent, especially if your speed is high like this.
Nani?
And then the next priority is the HP, because without HP, okay guys, the 10% passive healing from this is not gonna do you much, and you need to have some sort of sustain if you wanna solo all these cancer CC units, obviously. Now what you don't wanna have in a Juno is high resistance like this one. But anyway, let's see how we can solo these G2 cancer players. Let's go. Now the reason my Juno has not been working at G2 and G3 is because I watched this video by Claytano that says crit damage Juno is the best. And since I was a fan, I believe in his build, and my Juno has not been working till recently after I revamped her rune into what we see. Okay, now with CC unit, it doesn't matter what unit you're gonna bring. They're gonna reset your ass, they're gonna kill your ass. Even Triana, guys. Triana's not gonna do shit. Even Laika is not gonna do it against CC. That's why your best bet is to outspeed, right? But with unit like Juno or Josephine, you actually get to solo them. There's just no way to beat heavy CC comp, especially Janna or NG. Okay, our Etna is dead. I'm not mad that he's dead because he has not been doing anything in this match. Always go for Oki, because Oki, unlike other CC unit, is not gonna land debuff on your unit like that. So Oki is a threat, we kill the Oki. Now look guys, look at the debuffs on our unit and how much we're gonna heal from the debuff. This is why I can't stress enough how much important HP is on your Juno. And Revenge, look at how many times you actually revenge this guy. Getting attack bar from the Revenge, which is huge. And having some attack on your Juno is actually nice. You have 100 crit rate with your Juno, might as well capitalize on that crit damage you're gonna get on the crit, right? And the second skill, of course. It's bonus! So there we go. If you guys wanna have a Juno that can compete at G2 and G3 level, soloing all these pesky CC users, then this is how I recommend building the Juno. Also guys, with this build, you can use her as stripper because Juno doesn't get CC'd. She will move and strip the opponent, unless if he gets reset by the attack bar with Ganymede, or reset the attack bar by Hathor, or got reset by Okeanos. You know what? Never mind. Bottom line is, don't build crit damage build. Forget about Claytano's video. Don't fall into the trap like me just because you're a fan. I trusted him and all this time my Juno's not working. But now I finally have a Juno that's working at G2 and G3. Wow, I can't wait to play with her more, guys. So I hope you guys had a good time with this video, and I'll catch you guys later with more Juno action in the future. Bye! Thank you. Hey guys, thanks for watching the video. If you guys like this video, make sure to hit the thumbs up and hit the bell button. Also, don't forget to follow me on Twitter and Discord, which you can find the link down below.